The Jay and the Peacock. A jay venturing into a yard where peacocks used to walk, found there a number of feathers which had fallen from the peacocks when they were molting. He tied them all to his tail and strutted down towards the peacocks. When he came near them, they soon discovered the cheat, and strutting up to him pecked at him and plucked away his borrowed plumes. So the jay could do no better than go back to the other jays, who had watched his behavior from a distance, but they were equally annoyed with him, and told him, "It is not only fine feathers that make fine birds."
Listen again.
The Jay and the Peacock. A jay venturing into a yard where peacocks used to walk, found there a number of feathers which had fallen from the peacocks when they were molting. He tied them all to his tail and strutted down towards the peacocks. When he came near them, they soon discovered the cheat, and strutting up to him pecked at him and plucked away his borrowed plumes. So the jay could do no better than go back to the other jays, who had watched his behavior from a distance, but they were equally annoyed with him, and told him, "It is not only fine feathers that make fine birds."
Listen again.
The Jay and the Peacock. A jay venturing into a yard where peacocks used to walk, found there a number of feathers which had fallen from the peacocks when they were molting. He tied them all to his tail and strutted down towards the peacocks. When he came near them, they soon discovered the cheat, and strutting up to him pecked at him and plucked away his borrowed plumes. So the jay could do no better than go back to the other jays, who had watched his behavior from a distance, but they were equally annoyed with him, and told him, "It is not only fine feathers that make fine birds."
Listen again.
The Jay and the Peacock. A jay venturing into a yard where peacocks used to walk, found there a number of feathers which had fallen from the peacocks when they were molting. He tied them all to his tail and strutted down towards the peacocks. When he came near them, they soon discovered the cheat, and strutting up to him pecked at him and plucked away his borrowed plumes. So the jay could do no better than go back to the other jays, who had watched his behavior from a distance, but they were equally annoyed with him, and told him, "It is not only fine feathers that make fine birds."
Listen again.
The Jay and the Peacock. A jay venturing into a yard where peacocks used to walk, found there a number of feathers which had fallen from the peacocks when they were molting. He tied them all to his tail and strutted down towards the peacocks. When he came near them, they soon discovered the cheat, and strutting up to him pecked at him and plucked away his borrowed plumes. So the jay could do no better than go back to the other jays, who had watched his behavior from a distance, but they were equally annoyed with him, and told him, "It is not only fine feathers that make fine birds."
Listen again.
The Jay and the Peacock. A jay venturing into a yard where peacocks used to walk, found there a number of feathers which had fallen from the peacocks when they were molting. He tied them all to his tail and strutted down towards the peacocks. When he came near them, they soon discovered the cheat, and strutting up to him pecked at him and plucked away his borrowed plumes. So the jay could do no better than go back to the other jays, who had watched his behavior from a distance, but they were equally annoyed with him, and told him, "It is not only fine feathers that make fine birds."
Listen again.
The Jay and the Peacock. A jay venturing into a yard where peacocks used to walk, found there a number of feathers which had fallen from the peacocks when they were molting. He tied them all to his tail and strutted down towards the peacocks. When he came near them, they soon discovered the cheat, and strutting up to him pecked at him and plucked away his borrowed plumes. So the jay could do no better than go back to the other jays, who had watched his behavior from a distance, but they were equally annoyed with him, and told him, "It is not only fine feathers that make fine birds."